Session 4 Disc 4 Electricity Electric Charges, Voltaic Cell, and Electric Current Electricity is the world's most useful form of energy. It is an adaptable source of energy that can be carried long distances along wires. It can also be changed into other forms of energy. In our homes and cars, these include light bulbs, toasters, ovens, television, appliances, computers, and tools. Electricity provides so much more than it can only be imagined. In industry, it powers machines, robots, tools, furnaces, and welding arcs. Hospitals depend on electricity to operate X-ray machines, scanners, heart and lung machines, as well as ventilators. It is vital for all forms of transport and communications and much more. Electricity is an invisible form of energy. It is derived from tiny negative charge particles inside an atom, called electrons. The atom has a central core called a nucleus. The atom's nucleus contains positive charged particles called protons. Orbiting this nucleus are the negative charged particles called electrons. In a normal atom, the total number of positive and negative charges are equal, canceling out the effect of the charges. The atom is said to be in a balanced state and is referred to as a balanced atom. If, however, these charges become unequal, the atom acquires an electric charge and is said to be an unbalanced atom. The animations show a balanced atom with 4 protons and 4 orbiting electrons. It also shows an unbalanced atom with 4 protons and 3 electrons. The atom has lost an electron and bears a positive charge. The quantity or amount of charge on a body or object is determined by the number of electrons in excess or less than the number of protons. It is measured in an international unit of measurement, called the coulomb. 1 coulomb represents a charge of 6.25 billion electrons on a material or an object. Below is a representation of an electric charge on a material or an object. Atoms of materials or object that lose or gain electrons become electrically charged and are called ions. When an atom loses electrons, the atom becomes positively charged and is called a positive ion. When an atom gains electron, the atom becomes negatively charged and is called a negative ion. The word electricity comes from a Greek word electron. Electron is a yellow, fossilized translucent tree gum or resin known as amber. Over 2,500 years ago, the Greeks experimented with electric charges. They observed that this amber had a mysterious force. When a piece of this amber was rubbed briskly on fur or wool and then brought close to very light objects, such as feathers, fibers, or hair, that they would mysteriously rise and cling to the amber. What the Greeks observed is known as static electricity. Rubbing or friction causes electrons that are in a material to move. The material is said to be charged with electricity. The process of causing an electric charge to be created is called electrification. The phenomenon is observed daily, such as we walk on carpet and then touch the door handle. We experience an electric shock. When dry hair is brushed, we hear a slight crackling sound. This is caused by electrification. The electric charges created within or on the surface of any object or material are confined to them, remaining stationary. The condition exists until the object or material that has a lack or surplus electrons. Thus, we have static electricity, which is electricity in a balanced state. Normally, the atoms in each material is simply in a balanced state. However, if the material is physically rubbed against each other, referred as electrification, some of the electrons are moved. There are 2 kinds of electric charges created during electrification. The material that loses the electron becomes positively charged, while the other material that gains them becomes negatively charged. The rubbing action or friction gives the electrons extra energy. This enables some of them to wander, always from its atom's nucleus, allowing them to be passed from one material to another. This is known as separating charges. These charges stay on the surface of the materials. While in metal objects, the charges would spread and disperse into the object. Experiments led to many observations regarding the behavior of electric charges on materials or objects. Some of these observations are seen in the following animation and text. When a rubber rod is rubbed briskly across a wood block material, the rod is negatively charged. When the rod is moved near an isolated conductor, that conductor also becomes electrically charged. The phenomenon is known as electrostatic induction. When the negative charged rod is placed near the conductor, the region or area nearest the rod will acquire a charge of the opposite polarity, in this case positive, while the regions or area from the charged rod will acquire a charge of the same sign or polarity as the charged rod, in this case negatively charged. These observations form the basis to create the laws of electrostatics. One law states that the region or area nearest the charged body or object will acquire a charge of the opposite sign or polarity of the charged body. The region farthest forms the charged body or object will acquire a charge of the same sign or polarity as the charged body. More observations form the basis for another law of electrostatics. Charged bodies or electric charges of similar signs or polarities repel each other. This is observed in the following animation. When two opposite charged bodies or pieces of material were placed close to one another, the bodies or material attracted each other. In this case, a negatively charged body is brought near a positively charged ball. If two similar charged bodies or pieces of material were placed close to one another, they repel each other. This is seen when the two positively charged objects are placed near each other below. The observation help explain how and why the charges are arranged the isolated conductor as they were. As the negative charged rod was moved from the wool became positively charged. When the negatively rod was placed near the isolated conductor, the electrons in the conductor were repelled to its opposite end. This caused this end of the conductor to become negatively charged, with the other end positive. If a glass rod were rubbed on a silk block, the rod would be positively charged. This charged rod causes electrons to rush towards it. This causes the end near the rod to be negatively charged, when its other end positively charged. Any material or object that an electric charge is readily transferred into is called a conductor. Most metals are good conductors. Some of the best conductors are gold, silver, copper, aluminum, tungsten, and iron. Materials that do not allow electric charges to be readily transferred into are called insulators. Good insulators are poor conductors. Glass, mica, hard rubber, paraffin, bakelite, sulfur, silk, shellac. Dry air and plastics are good insulators. These insulators are referred to as dielectrics. Static electricity builds up around different non-metal materials if the materials are rubbed together. Depending on the type of charge placed on the material's surface, will determine if the material will attract or repel one another. On the other hand, static electricity can be destructive as in creating lightning strikes. It can also cause interference in satellites, television, radio, plus so much more.